sky is so high. If you don't know how to fly, aim for laser to make you fly. Sky is so high. If you don't know how to fly, aim for laser to make you fly. Here we go. Has everybody done the homework? Yes, no, maybe.
Yes.
You said maybe.
What is that?
We have like little loudly, maybe. Can you guys hear her?
Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am. No. Not proper.
Okay. I'm Supriya. It's okay, take your time.
Yeah,
if you guys are comfortable, come.
Not necessarily, but just so that they can hear.
Or you can be loud. Whatever suits you. I'm Supriya Pujari. I'm 23 years old from Mumbai. I'm pursuing my aviation diploma from MPhil International, Mumbai. And also done my post-graduation. Calm down. Okay, that's what I want you guys. Also done my post-graduation from Rajiv Gandhi University. I'm a good communicator. My hobbies are dancing, traveling, and cooking. My family, we are two members, my mom and me.
So when you say that you are a good communicator, what is it that you mean? Like, what is it that you are trying to tell the interviewer or anybody in general, or now? Say for instance you have to deny something to someone, how will you communicate that to Just think like vaguely, doesn't have to be right, it's fine even if it's wrong, but just Rohan and Fayaz. It's okay, say for instance, I'm asking you for something and you're not able to give that to me. It's a no. So how will you communicate that? Because communication involves different aspects, right? It's not always about just talking for the yeses and talking for things that you are going to give someone. Sometimes you have to say a no to the customer or to the person. So how will you use your skills at that point?
Material.
It's not available
yes.
with us.
Yeah, that's not available with us. So I'm extremely sorry for you.
You're sorry for me. No, what did you say? I'm extremely sorry.
Sorry.
You can say I'm extremely sorry for the inconvenience. However, at this point of time, I am not in a position to help you. I would have absolutely loved to help you, but right now, I'm not in the position. That's fine. With not that fear. I know right now you're a little nervous or whatever. That is fine. With time, you will get that. But at least know what you have to speak. Simple. The practice will happen eventually.
Priyansh.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Basically, I'm here.
Tell me about yourself. My name is Priyesh Babarya.
I
live in Chembur. I'm in last year of my degree college. I have done the course of cabin crew from MPhil International. In my family, there are my mom, dad, and my brother. My brother is a doctor, my dad is a serviceman, and my mom is a housewife.
Just that whoever's answering, please be louder. Okay, they can hear you, but y'all cannot be. You're not audible there. Ma'am, you can ask them also.
Yeah.
And my hobbies are traveling and weightlifting. And my strength is that I'm calm in every situation.
Are you telling me that you're going to say something else,
no,
or is it a full stop?
Full stop.
You're family and the situation and ends. But you remember yesterday I mentioned something that when you are going to talk about yourself, don't make it a very robotic kind of whatever, monologue. One thing is not being a little confident, the other thing is you don't know what you're saying. Or you're just probably read it out and you are speaking it. There are two different things. There is nothing in between. I can understand that when it comes to confidence and when it comes to the practice of speaking in front of people, it takes time. It will happen eventually, no doubt. However, you have to be very clear about what you're speaking. If you're going to stick to the same 5-6 lines that you have come across in your life and you don't want to modulate and you don't want to improvise it, then I'm not sure. Because there has to be some sort of a growth factor, right? I know we don't learn everything from the beginning, we learn it over time. There has to be, like I already mentioned yesterday, that take cues from what I'm saying and just put in some efforts to make the content like that. That is all I'm saying. Even if you're fumbling, even if you're nervous, even if you're not probably, you know, in that whole confidence zone, it's fine. But I want you to at least have some solid content to speak. Yes, man. It's fine. And what about why should I hire you? Like yesterday you were completely blank about that. So at least today you tell me what.
Written, but I'm not sure is it correct or not.
You can read it out. She did the same.
Yes.
You can get the book and read it out.
I've written in my phone.
What the?
I've written in notes in my phone.
So do you remember it?
Yeah, I can, but not fluent, but I can tell.
At least try.
Yes. Yeah. Sir, as ma'am, as I'm not special and there are many candidates over there and freshers, but I have a hunger to learn about new things and I'm passionate about your company and this job.
This is what I'm saying. So it feels like I'm taking viva. Like, person shouldn't feel like they're taking a viva, then you'll be like, you can't do that, right? Like, it's not professional. We need to get out of the college mentality or the school mentality and do what we are supposed to do, because you are choosing to do this, right? Nobody, can you like just calm down? I'm not roasting you, it's just fine. This is just gonna help you, I believe, in whatever it's way possible. It's just okay, just relax. It's fine. It's your chest. Okay, someone online wants to tell me about themselves or why should I hire you? Have you done the assignment? Are you guys there?
Yes, ma'am.
So would you like to add some value to today's session? Yesterday we discussed about tell me something about yourself and why should I hire you? So have you guys worked on that? Yes, no, maybe. I need an answer, please.
No, ma'am.
Why is that so? Are you guys going to speak?
Yes, ma'am.
Who is that? Who is that? Shweta? Is that Shweta? That's the first one is the one who's speaking.
That's Parvati.
Parvati? Sorry, I can't hear you.
Am I doing that?
Okay, but is there anybody who's prepared with some content?
Nobody's talking about it.
Would you like to add some value by letting all of us know? Say the interviewer asks you a question, why should I hire you? How will you answer that? Could you please, anybody of you, give like a gist of it so that everybody can also hear today? At least acknowledge Because I need to know if
Hello.
Yes, please.
Okay, my name is Jelpo. You can hear me because
yes.
I'm a hard worker. And I always try to help others.
You are answering, why should I hire you? Is that so?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, go on.
Ma'am, the sound is reflecting. Return it to me.
Sorry? Please bear with it because like there's too much of connections happening here, so I don't think I can do much about it, but I am able to hear you, so if you can please tell me whatever you were mentioning about why should I hire you?
I can help others. Whatever the situation may be, help them.
Okay.
And I will work sincerely to the company.
Okay. And.
Okay, then. I was always ready to help.
So you are trying to say that you are a very helpful candidate. Is that so?
Yeah, ma'am.
So it's the same. Yeah. Thank you for your input, Jean. I'll get back to you.
Okay, thank you.
I have written this, ma'am. Why should we hire you? Okay. So, I want to work into an aviation, and your company is one of the best I have known. And I'm a hard worker, quick learner, and I'm also passionate about delivering excellent customer service. So, if you hire me, then it will help me to make my career into aviation, and also I will become a valuable asset in your company.
You can also add that, say for instance, I'm not sure what it was, a call center, right? Yeah, it was a call center, voice process, only customer service process. But what was the area like? Process, Bark India,
it is related to PRP measurement. So the customer who called us regarding their issues, and we tried to solve their issues.
So you can just add a line that, you know, I have previous customer service experience and the knowledge to handle the customers and their needs, which I feel will be very helpful for the particular job that I have signed up for. Just one line, but this is very nice. This is something that I'm talking about. He saw it. Maybe he was not as confident, but at least he has some extra points apart from just the normal points, the basic points which we all have probably got. That's great.
Thank you.
And what about tell me something about yourself?
Ma'am, and for that part, I tried to improve my introduction part, but I only done these things only yesterday what I told you. So if you could give us yesterday only I was trying to say you. So you explain us, you give your introduction to us, then we understand how we have to give the introduction to.
You make a note of it, so then.
Yeah, sure. That's right. If you we have that material that steps with us, but if you give us your introduction, then we get to know how we have.
I have a write up which I probably anticipated that will be needed. So even the guys online, if you want to make a note of it, feel free to do that. If you want to add something, feel free to do that. This is something which is only going to be like a skeleton. Not something that you have to mug up and you have to exactly say. This is my understanding. I am giving it to you. If it makes sense to you, if you are able to pull it off, do it.
You will get idea how we have to take it.
Fair enough. You can always add, you can always tweak the adjectives as per you guys. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Yes, yes ma'am, it's fine.
Thank you, ma'am.
Suddenly there's so many of them, and I was asking about who is anyone prepared, no one wants to speak that night. Asa?
Yes.
So, my name is so, whatever. Just tell me if I can go ahead. So.
Yes.
A very determined, optimist, proactive, highly driven individual. You can ask me if there's anything you don't understand.
Ma'am, can you please repeat it?
Yes, I am. A very determined, optimistic, proactive, highly driven individual.
Highly
driven individual. Professionally, I have an experience of so and so, whatever you have. If you don't have, we'll take care of that. But first, if you have experience, professionally, I have an experience of so and so years. Or if you want to mention the field, so and so field. And if you have no experience, then currently I am a fresher, looking to add value to your organization and also to my own skills.
Ma'am, can you please repeat it once again?
Which part? So, it's professionally, I have an experience of so and so. And if you are a fresher, you write, currently I don't have any experience, so currently I'm a fresher. And looking forward to add value with whatever knowledge I have. Also, why are you doing this?
I'm listening.
Okay. Also, to gain any sort of an knowledge from your end or this experience. From this experience or this job. Again, please feel free to use any sort of words. This is something I am thinking and doing. It's not a script or I haven't gotten it from somewhere. So you can always add whatever you want to add as per your comfort. Okay? So,
looking forward to gain knowledge from your organization, company or sector.
Field.
Field.
That makes sense to me. And when you are saying like I have experience of so and so years or whatever, then you say, like I mentioned, that based on my experience, you know, I will be possibly be able to add this sort of an input. So whatever input you think you have based on your experience, you chip in that line. Is that okay? And if you're a fresher, say the qualification that I have or the degree I have, I feel I have the theoretical knowledge to actually bring it to action or to practice it in your company or your organization or this particular field. Make sense?
Yes, nice.
Then the way you guys were talking about your family, then you go on and also about my family. We are a member of 3, 4, whatever. And then you want to speak about what your father does, and if you have a sibling, you speak about that. Then you come to the skills and interests or your hobbies. In my leisure time, I like to do so and so. Reading is a passion, or I like to travel and I've been to this place and it was an amazing experience. If you're going for an airline and you know you have probably traveled for the first time or so, speak about that. You know, my first flight was to so and so destination, it was a family trip. It's just about your understanding or whatever experience you have that you can put across. Is that okay? Does this make sense now for you, what I was saying?
Yes.
For everybody as well? So are you going to elevate from the same way of putting it across now? Is it better now?
Yes, yes.
And people online, did you also, were you able to hear everything?
Yes,
so the next is, why should we hire you? So I also have a skeleton for that. again, you feel free to tweak, feel free to add, disregard, up to you. So when it comes to hiring part, if you're going for a crew job, it's very important you know what is, it's not only about traveling or the service. It is also about the fact that you are responsible for the safety and security of the customers on board. So when you are speaking about like whatever you said you have so and so qualities in you, you also mentioned that I am very well aware that my job involves a lot of responsibility. That I am responsible for the safety and security of the people right from the time they board up until the time they disembark. So the person knows that this person has that understanding and the idea that this is not only about traveling, this is not only about service. It is also a very responsible job where you will be trained for probably 2-3 months and then you will have an exam and you are responsible for evacuation or whatever is if an emergency arises. So you can mention that point that if you in future go for an interview or whatever, you can mention the awareness of safety and security. Elaborate as per your likings. What I'm saying in a whole is that me as a person, I have an awareness of the safety and security involved in this job profile. Even if it's a ground job like on the airport, still there are some safety aspects that they train you on. So you can always mention because airports are high risk places. So which part? This is not supposed to be the start. What I'm saying is you guys already have the parts of where you're talking about yourself or you want to work with the company and so on and so forth. What I'm saying is when you're talking about those things which you already know, add the fact that you know what, I'm a responsible person and I'm aware that the job profile that I'm signing up for has the aspect of safety and security, which is, you know, revolving around the customers on board and all of that jazz, which you have to do. You don't have to give, but it's well and good that you put it across that way. So there was another point that a lot of you were making, that you're passionate about traveling and how you want to explore places and so on and so forth. There's something that you can mention that I am very passionate about traveling and it makes me feel really good that I would be a part of somebody's journey to go from point A to point B. So this is a very empathetic statement. You're making a statement based on somebody you don't know. The customer is someone you will never see again probably. So you're saying that it makes you feel good since you love traveling, whether the person is going for a family visit, work or leisure, whatever. You are going to be a part of that journey. You're going to provide them service, the comfort or maybe handling the baggage, whatever that you're good for. So you can mention that, you know, it makes me feel good that I will be a part of that journey with the customer to help him reach from point A to point B. And your organization would be giving that chance to me to probably achieve my dream or do that for someone I don't even know or I don't think. So these kind of lines really give an angle of a very thoughtful person. Someone who's thinking beyond the normal thing that I want to travel or I just want to explore places or I want to meet new people. And when you go on an aircraft, you don't go and talk to all the customers. All you do is greet them. You ask them whether they want to eat or no, depending on the kind of airline you're working for. So it's a very cliche and a very fake statement that I like to meet people and traveling, of course, people like is fine, but meet people you know you're not going to have any kind of solid interaction with them. Until unless you're working for an airline which flies 16 hours. That time you have a scope of flying, talking to the person when you know there are like no services happening. Otherwise, for quick flights, Indian flights, it's not possible. So when you talk about things, you also have to think about these aspects. Which airline are you applying for? What are the sectors they fly? What is the duration of that flight? And so on. So you can mention this if it makes sense to you that you want to be a part of people's journey. And apart from that, one thing that they... You're driving?
No.
You're writing something? Are you guys able to hear?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have any questions?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
That's okay. What do you think is the one of the most important things that the employer, say for a crew job, looks at? Probably in all jobs, but in crew job mainly. What do you think? One thing that is, it's common in all job profiles, but in crew it's slightly a little more important. No, like something
should be hiring.
They should be motivated, they should have patience, but there's something which can make or break the flight. Could be the ground of operation of that flight, the smooth operation of that flight. Something else, something that involves other people as well, not only you. It is absolutely very, 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 very important because you don't fly with the same set of people. Even if you're on, say for instance, a ground job and you have probably the same shift, you still will not do the same allocation with the boss. You always change. So, you know, when you're working in a corporate setup or when you're in a place where you're meeting the same people again and again, you develop that kind of a rapport. You develop that kind of an understanding, or okay, this one is, you know, a little bit hard to handle, this one is okay, or whatever that is. You understand the person's personality. But when you're flying with people or when you're working in jobs which are rotational shift jobs, you are going to meet people who are different every single day. So highlighting that aspect of you understanding that, not just saying that I'm a good team player or a person who is really good at teamwork. What do you mean by that? Again, I want to know if you're aware of what you're saying. Maybe not everybody will say that. Everyone will just say that I'm a good team player. You have an added advantage if you say that I understand that I'm not going to work with the same set of people. I'm going to have different set of people. I feel that I have the flexibility of adapting. I have the understanding of probably, you know, working with different people. And I have that kind of a personality that I am okay to adapt. So, you know, this is how you frame things. This is how you make it a little more realistic and not robotic. You can add this point as well. And the rest things that you guys already know is something that you can merge with this. You don't have to follow this flow. This is something which I feel they are sort of like highlights. Something that is beyond the normal things that you will tell the interviewer about. Why should they hire? This only comes from somebody who knows how it works. So you need to know where you're going to interview and how it works. And how from those, the way that the organization or the setup or the company works, you can just put in lines from that particular process. You know, I can do so because I'm so. So two things, one thing self-awareness and the other thing the understanding of how that organization works or that sector works, or how is it that you can add value. That's how you can frame things. Yes, no, maybe?
That's yes.
Okay. Is there anybody else who tried to follow the guidelines that I gave yesterday? I know today it's a little more elaborate, but kind of meant the same thing when I was speaking yesterday. But anybody else wants to try? Do you want to try now after you have an understanding of, or you want to take your time and?
No, I understand what should I have to like add on my, but still I just give me time.
Have you done like? You'll try to work or you will work on it. Two different things. Fair enough. fair enough. Is there anything you want to ask? Ask me. Like he asked me that, you know, there's like a skeleton, I will be able to work on it. So is there anything that you guys want to ask? Feel free to ask.
I will definitely try that, but the words or the sentences
you don't understand, ask me. Rather, this was something that I wanted to know from you guys, and am I just going bouncer?
Means like, you need to slow down a little bit, like, explain.
I'll slow down, and if there's any word or sentence that doesn't make sense to you, when you feel that I'm going fast, tell me, just say, excuse me, I'm not able to understand, could you please slow down?
Yes.
Anybody else also, just say, because even I need feedback, I'm a human being as well, so I need to know how I'm not aligned with you guys, because I am training as per my understanding, but when you say that, sorry, I'm not understanding, or you're too fast, or you're too slow, I don't get your words, tell me. Don't just let the time pass and then feel like, oh, I didn't understand anything. Thanks for the feedback. Okay, and the next thing that we spoke yesterday was about the resume.
Yes.
So, did you guys do anything about it, or again, it's just... on your building. Has anybody worked on it?
I have PDF.
You are just for a second. I have PDF.
Like end of the lecture, I'll show you. Then just give me an idea what should I have, like, improve.
I cannot even see the
PDF.
Content of the guide online. So I have some pointers for the resume as well, and I'll just probably read it out to you or explain it to you, and then probably you'll be a little more clear to work on it.
Okay.
I've done my part, so now after this it'll be your part of implementing it.
Sure.
Which I think you guys already know, but somebody yesterday asked about the crew format. So. This, I think you asked. Labani. Or Ankita. Okay, anybody of either?
Labani.
Okay, somebody asked about the crew format, but
to be honest,
yeah, you did. But to be honest, like I said, there's no format as such. There are just a couple of things here and there that you have to add. So make a note if you want. I just have the skeleton of it, and you guys can prepare it. Okay. Guys, did you hear that?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Asta?
Yes.
So, as we all know, we need to put our name. The name has to be in bold. Then comes the email ID, which is not supposed to be partial.cooldude@gmail.com. So let us just get out of that. If we have those email IDs, then please create a new one which has your name, your last name, or only your name, or something which is professional, which you can use on like wherever you're sending your resume. Then comes your contact number. Sorry? There's name, the email ID, and after that contact number. In some airlines, it is sort of a mandate thing when they check the age limit. So it's recommended that you put up your date of birth. Like, do not put the age like 20, 21 or 22 years, just put like whatever is your date of birth, your date of birth. So that they know you're 18 and above or 21 and above, because some airlines have that sort of a limit. So they can just skim your resume according to that. Next two things.
We can just add that date of birth and our personal information.
You mean the email that you will draft?
No, like the personal information, the language we know, the date of birth and stuff. Like,
what I'm saying is, if you're sending a crew resume or for a crew job, just keep it very easy, like on the air. This is something you start with, like whatever, on the right or left side, so that the person easily knows like what is hypothetically the age of this person. If you want to put it in your personal details, it's up to you, it's your choice. But this is what I also, since I have an understanding of how the organizations, especially international organizations, work, I think I would recommend that you just put it up somewhere in the start.
So it should be in one line, like
not in one line, probably like one after the other. Now the formatting has to be taken care of, like depending on your font, depending on like the spacing and everything. So it's up to you what looks aesthetic to you. Feel free to do that. Okay. Next two things are the passport number. That is again majorly if you're applying for international airline. Indian Airlines, I'm not sure, because generally they want to know that you have a valid passport for 6 months or so. There's some sort of this criteria, which they anyway ask you when in the later stages. This is just being like proactive and providing the information. Last thing is the complete address. Again, depending on the airline, you want to put it, you put it for all airlines, they are not going to disregard it, but this is more so for people for hiring from outside India, that you know, like which state or which part of India or any other country is this person applying for. So the complete address. And photograph is something which a lot of us put on our resume, which is a good thing that you have a photograph. But also I feel that when you are going through the interview process, they are going to ask you to take a picture in a particular attire, particular background, and the hair in whatever ways, and what they want the makeup to be like, the smile to be like. So if you already have a recent picture, well and good, go ahead and put it. But it's up to you if you want to do the job twice. Or if you have some contact from that airline you're applying from, get to know the standards. If you have some particular airline which you have like a real, real passion to work with, get to know the standards, that what are the background, what is the background they need, what is the kind of makeup they need, the hair they need, the clothes they need, like full sleeves, half sleeves, skirt, trousers. Get it done so that you're already prepared, you don't have to do the job twice. Or if you're comfortable, already have, go ahead and put your passport size.
So the photograph is compulsory?
It's not compulsory, honestly, it's not. But for a crew job, I would say it's 60-40,
okay.
Because they anyway ask you for a passport size and a full size photograph separately along with your resume. So that's what I'm saying, it's like up to you. You want to put it in your resume or you don't. After that, I think we all know there's something called as career objective. But if you are an experienced candidate, I would recommend that you write a professional summary.
About past experience.
Like, I have an example for that. See, this is for you want to make a note of it? I think it should be, if you want to, because most of us have what was that? Why are we looking up and smiling?
Actually, I was shaking my leg, so she just looked at me like...
That's annoying, right? Yeah. So if you have experience, this is something that that makes sense to me. So I have put it down. You want to make a note of it, feel free to do it. Or if you're okay with the current objective, that is fine too. So people online, can you also hear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So, for a professional summary, it can go as a well-presented, confident individual. Are you guys writing?
Yes.
This is a professional summary. So, this is basically for someone. But you can note it down because tomorrow you will also be an experienced candidate, right? You will always update your CV.
A well-presented
and confident individual. With proven ability to provide exceptional ability to provide exceptional customer service. With proven ability to provide exceptional customer service. Unmute.
Parvati,
if you could please unmute.
Sound.
Having XYZ years of experience, whatever years of experience that you have. This is a professional summary. Can you imagine that you've been there, done that, and now you have experience? Just keep it, like maybe you'll use it in future, you can use it.
We can't use it as measures.
This is more so speaking about the experience that you've had and what you can provide to the organization you are applying for, or the position you're applying for.
So is it your experience?
As a cabin crew.
Or?
Whatever experience that you have. So that's why I'm saying just feel free to tweak the things that I'm saying. I might give you one skeleton, you can add and tweak as per whatever experiences you have. But this is an understanding of how you can make the professional sound. So now here, what I have done is I have mentioned about the one of this USP of the particular airline. So experience as a cabin crew with world's five-star airline as per Skytrax records for so years. So this shows that I know what organization was I working for, not just the name, but also what the organization has achieved. So, or you know, like there are a lot of things, like even if you're applying for Indigo and if you have experience with Indigo, they have this on-time performance awards and, you know, like customer service awards that even Indian DGCA provides or something on those lines. So you can, you know, always research and try for if you're upgrading for a senior position or so. And if you have experience of customer service, whatever were your merits, just put it there. You have experience of. So whatever is that suits you, use it in this skeleton and just tweak it as per your experience. Yes, no, maybe. Why are you so disturbed? Is that okay for everybody?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Now, if you are a fresher and you are writing like a career objective, again, the same jazz, it goes like, I'll start.
Yes.
A highly motivated and friendly personality.
Yes.
Looking for a responsible position. to gain professional and personal experience. To gain professional and personal experience, or you can say to gain practical experience. Just make it so, looking for a responsible position to gain practical experience. Using my interpersonal skills. And you can chip in the same line, instead of putting personal and professional over there, make it so to achieve goals for professional and personal growth. Make sense? To achieve goals for professional and personal growth. So the only thing that is done here is the usage of I am so and so. I am this. I want to do this. It's kind of replaced. Replaced to tweak the statement. That's the only thing you have to keep in mind in future also when you're communicating with someone or you're making a resume or you're writing something professional. It's only about how you tweak the sentences and then add whatever inputs you have. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
And I have to add this CV. This could be your career objective. Up to you how you tweak it or if you want to stick to this. It's absolutely as per you, but this is just like a skeleton to help you if required. Let's just break for 5 minutes and then...
Ma'am.
Yes, please.
About the job.
I can't hear you, I'm sorry. Could you please repeat?
Okay, one second. Is it includes the industry in the job?
Does it include what? Industry job. Is that what you asked?
Personal interest and passionate. How passionate I was in that job.
You mean in professional summary?
Not passion. To include the content about the passion.
He's asking that.
Are you asking about the professional summary that I mentioned a while ago?
Ma'am, anything professional, sorry ma'am, passion, if I include the passion on the resume.
You can definitely include your passion, but what the point is that if you're writing a professional summary, and in that summary, if you're telling or you're portraying that, you know, you worked for so-and-so airline and this is what you did, try and keep it very crisp and short, because anyway when you're going to talk to the employer, you're going to talk about yourself, so let the resume be as short and crisp as possible.
Okay.
Does that make sense to you, Jen? Right, Jen?
Yes ma'am.
So feel free to write and tweak as per your understanding, but whatever you write, try and keep it as short and crisp as possible.
Okay, ma'am.
We'll just break for 5 minutes and get back. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Thank you.
Okay.
Is everybody here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. If anybody interested in with the French classes, you can leave a message. To me, okay? This is Nargis ma'am here.
Okay, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.